Ladies and gents, Captain Van here. Time out po muna tayo sa pagiging karpintero, but instead, in this episode, I will try to address and hopefully manage your fear of flying in the middle of pandemic. Hello and welcome back. If you are new to my channel, my name is Van Ranyoa. I am an airline pilot and a woodworker based in the Philippines. If you are interested in aviation, woodworking, and do-it-yourself builds, then this might be the channel for you. I invite you to subscribe and click that notification bell so that you'll get updated weekly on my latest builds and happenings here at Capitantero. My dear passengers, it's almost a year since the lockdown started, and a lot of things have changed, especially the way we travel. And the aviation industry is trying to deliver that message that flying in the middle of pandemic is not as dangerous as you think. And that is the purpose of this video, to give you facts, explain to you how the aircraft system works, and try to give you an idea on how the airline companies are trying to double up their safety measures in fighting this pandemic. Here's a fact. There's a recent study conducted by the International Air Transport Association, or IATA, that out of 1.2 billion people who flew last year, only 44 cases have been reported to have acquired the virus, which is air travel related. And part of that has something to do with the seat orientation of the aircraft, the way the air flows inside the cabin, and the importance of HEPA filter. So ano nga ba ang HEPA filter? Hindi po yan yung sakit tulad nung iniisip ng iba. Ang ibig pong sabihin niyan ay high efficiency particulate air, which is 99.9% effective in removing viruses, bacteria, and fungi. To give you an idea on how the system works, for example, this is the aircraft. I happen to fly the Airbus 320, and the HEPA filters of the Airbus 320 are installed at the bottom part of the aircraft. There's a reason kung bakit dyan yan nakalagay, which you'll find out later. So imagine that this is the front view of the cabin. We as a pilot, we make sure to maintain a high flow rate inside the cabin. And the way the system works, the air comes from the top, going down on a circular motion before it goes back up again on another cycle. So air is coming from the overhead bin, your own personal vents, the top side vents, before it goes down doon sa ating HEPA filter, removes the virus and bacteria, before it releases it back on top, giving you a fresh air in every 2 to 3 minutes. That's how the HEPA filter works. So aside from the airflow, meron din kinalaman ang orientation ng seats ng aircraft, which is facing forward sa paglessen ng risk ng transmission ng virus. The front seat will act as a barrier in case someone coughed, and given that he is wearing a face mask, with a high airflow rate coming from the top should have pushed the virus down towards the HEPA filter, keeping that person in front of him safe. So ano nga ginagawa ng mga airline companies to double up their safety measures? In my company, all of our aircrafts undergo a daily disinfection and cleaning process. Some of the airline already adopt to the contactless booking process to lessen the risk of transmission. And in my company, all pilots and cabin crew are required to have their antigen test every 14 days, and you need to have that fit to fly clearance in order for you to attend your duties. Ganyan po kaseryoso ang airlines in dealing with this pandemic. Now, this will only work if the passengers will do their part. Kaya bago po tayo mag-book ng ticket, alamin po na natin yung mga travel requirements ng local government unit na pupuntahan natin. And make sure to bring all your travel documents bago po tayo pumunta sa airport to avoid hassle. Some airports dito sa atin, gumagamit sila ng contact tracing app, and it's good to know kung ano yung app na yon para you can download that on your cell phone before going to the airport. Remember that wearing face shield and face mask is mandatory, kaya wag na wag po natin kakalimutan yan. Most importantly, follow all the instructions from your cabin crew during the boarding and deplaning process, and listen to all of the announcements coming from the flight crew. Just a tip, just in case you are afraid of heights, you can always request for an aisle seat para hindi nyo makita yung view sa labas. You can also bring your own alcohol provided that it will not exceed 100 ml, and put it on a clear bottle para hindi kayo mahirapan sa screening process. And I suggest to keep yourself hydrated, and kung maaari, kumain na po kayo na madami before going to your flight. Dahil remember, tumataas ang risk natin every time we remove our mask in public to eat. So there you go, ladies and gents. I hope I was able to minimize your fears and doubts in flying during this time of pandemic. Rest assured that all airline companies are doing its best to give you that peace of mind that you need in case you decide that you're ready to fly again. If you like this video, don't forget to subscribe, and I hope you can help me share this information to your families and to your friends so that we can help this struggling aviation industry to get back on its feet. This has been your captain, Van Ranyowa. Keep safe, and I hope to see you in one of my future flights.